try as a vent and probably maybe put on a new. I'm in a cruise ship. I'm tired of this water in the kitchen. But how else am I gonna get it? 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 I'm getting kinda tired of all this in the kitchen. How else am I gonna get it? How else am I gonna get it?
Hello everyone, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. The stakes have been raised here in the wild card round, as it's time to win or get an early start on the offseason. It's the Steelers going up against the Ravens. With that, we'll send you up to Baltimore, and standing by at M&T Bank Stadium are the two men who'll call the action. That's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, thanks. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Inner Harbor and M&T Bank Stadium in Baltimore, Maryland. Straight ahead, we pull the curtain on the postseason with an AFC wild card matchup between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Baltimore Ravens. This is Buck Allen, and he's going to be stopped here on this first play as he gets it to the line of scrimmage and no more. This offense can be flashy at times, and a big reason for that is Perriman.
I like the way you use the word big, because that's exactly what Breshad Perriman is, a big receiver with a ton of speed, runs so well, yet that strength downfield really confounds defensive backs. Is it okay if I tell you I played against his dad in college?
Well, I'm just impressed that you work confounds into the broadcast.
I'm impressed I'm still alive because I played against his dad in college. Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop him?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
Firing quickly here, and that's complete. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and that'll make it a second down. And a look at the Steelers' defensive unit.
Cameron Hayward is a defensive lineman, but many of us, especially guys of my vintage, remember his father, Craig Ironhead Hayward, who was a running back. I think Cameron decided he'd rather hit people than be hit.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Flacco gives to Allen. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. He lost 2 there. And it's third down.
All right, partner. Despite my eating habits, I'm not big enough to play offensive tackle, nor am I quick enough. But with the defensive ends nowadays and their speed, those guys have to be able to punch and dance. And it's a tough, tough job to contain them.
The first down line at the 34 here on third down. Third down, Flacco needs a decent chunk of yardage. And he's got a man open, that's Allen. And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22. They were ready for what the defense was showing. They had prepared for that look, recognized it, went straight to the air, got the first. Well done.
Love the recognition, because you can prepare for everything. You can watch the tape and put together your game plan, but you still have to understand what they're doing in terms of what they're showing and be able to adjust accordingly, and they did exactly that.
Red zone opportunity. Tight right. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Second down, Flacco now. This will be caught at about the 3. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far on the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
They'll run. This is Allen. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Baltimore. Buck Allen with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Ravens have taken the early lead. And the Ravens lead at 7-0. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now a carry for the former Michigan State man, Le'Veon Bell. And he's brought down. It'll go as a gain of 10 there. And the Steelers are going to have a first down.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills? And it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's something. Speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, that led to a really nice game.
Offensive starters time. Electric is certainly a word that comes to mind when you talk about Le'Veon Bell.
Love the way that he reshaped his body coming out of college. A bigger, thicker runner while he was at Michigan State. Lost weight, became more of a whippet in the NFL. And now no one can tackle the guy, whether he's running it or catching it.
Another 2-yard gain there, but they'll need to do better this time. It's 3rd and 6. So they run it on 2nd down. Now let's see what 3rd down brings here for the offense. On 3rd down, Roethlisberger. Austin's got it left side. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
On 1st and 10, it's Roethlisberger. This is caught by Antonio Brown. And a loose football. And it's picked up by the Ravens. And the return will actually lose 11 yards. But they get the interception. They have the football. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And that last drive, a long drive. But not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Keep it on the ground. Allen again. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's 3rd down.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up the play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
15 yards through the air and a 1st down.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. 1st down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Second down following the incompletion. And they're going to go soft on the corners. Incomplete on 1st down. Now Flacco on 2nd. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
Fake to Allen. Here's Flacco. And that will be caught, but out of bounds. Out of bounds, ruled incomplete here. A third down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, and that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out, trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And a fumble last time. Ball security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about, what, the second sentence of the coach's address?
And those are so many drills focus on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to simulate game situations.
Looking for Austin, intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, C.J. Mosley. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackle was there right away for a loss of yardage.
Flacco here on second down, underneath to Allen, and he gets it down to the 32. 7 yards on the play, and they're going to face a third down. Second quarter now, Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis with you. It's the Ravens who have the football. They'll come up on a third and four here to start things out. Taken down at the 25. The defense came out with a look that they had prepped for all week to attack. They took advantage, got the first down.
And the key words in there, prepped for all week. They really studied them, understood their tendencies, knew what they liked to do, and prepared their game plan accordingly. And boy, the payoff was good.
They'll get a couple yards on that one, and it'll make it a second down.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, did a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. It's third down, 6 yards to go for the offense. Stay on the ground with Allen. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. Call it a gain of 5. Fourth down now.
But forget knowing where the first down line was. His defense created their own line of scrimmage. They won every battle up front. And a lot of times that is one-on-one. If you win your one-on-ones enough times, your defense is going to be pretty good. They have more people to the football and snuffed out the play.
So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point, so no problems converting there.
The Steelers' offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Now Roethlisberger going to hand to Bell, and he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Calling no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a third and about 3 to go. Roethlisberger now to throw on third down. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. Give him 8 yards on the play, and they pick up the first.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they're going to just roam and hit.
Trying to get it there to Martavis Bryant, and it'll bring up third down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
And defensively, Baltimore's in a dime look here on third. From the gun on third down, it's Roethlisberger. And able to find Green. And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic. So anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even added a little extra at the end with a short run.
Brown, the lone receiver left. Now Roethlisberger to throw on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. On third down, Roethlisberger. He's going to rifle one deep left side, and he can't come up with a pick. Nearly his second of the game. Instead, fourth down. The Steelers send out their punter now. Back deep is Devin Hester. And he'll try and keep this away from Hester as this is going toward the sideline. And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line. Here comes the Raven offense now, ready for another possession. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up. But they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Got to give some credit there defensively. They snuffed out that screen early on first down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see it break down as the passer, I think in this situation, you're throwing it in the feet of your back to make sure no one picks it off, or you throw it away, throw it over the sideline. Don't try and freelance and try and make a bigger play.
That's caught at the 25. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back with more AFC playoff action after this timeout. Now Roethlisberger on first down. He's going to take a shot and caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. Ladarius Green, his ninth touchdown of the season. And the Steelers are able to make this a close game again. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now. Now it's Brinza to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he probably should have stayed in the end zone as he'll muster a return up to only the 14-yard line. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. They go back to the air here after the INT. He's got time. He's going to go up top again. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. The Steelers' offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent, but you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. And he rifles one incomplete.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. Again on second and 10, it's Roethlisberger. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. The Ravens' offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. They get the pick. Now what can Flacco do on first down? And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Now a play fake here on first down. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. First and 10, and Flacco looking to throw. He's going to air one out. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And the Steelers set to take the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Again, it's Bell. Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Final play of the half, it's Roethlisberger. He's going to rifle one deep left side, and he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. So we're at halftime of this AFC wild card matchup as we send you down to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando, where we find our man Larry Ridley with our halftime report. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. The Steeler offense now with the football first here to begin the third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. This is Bell on the dump off. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Now the Ravens bring out an extra defensive back here on third down.
Could be a blitzer.
And this is going to be incomplete. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
So the punt rolls out of bounds, and they'll have pretty good field position here up near the 40-yard line. The Ravens offense getting ready now for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away.
Yeah,
defense,
we got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
It goes as a gain of 8. It moves the chains.
In my book, that's running the ball well, but with intelligence. How about him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds?
Yeah, even though it's the third quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where your running game can really help you with a lead in the second half.
I agree totally. It's not just end of the half situations that you worry about the clock. It's throughout the game. And with a lead, stay in bounds. Make them fight harder to try and catch you.
Flacco from midfield. And it's grabbed by Crockett Gilmore. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything. And sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker. Whenever we meet with coaches and they always talk about wanting to establish running the football, it's oftentimes with a good tight end who can control the line of scrimmage and the point of attack. And
Allen hit. He lost the football. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet there are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they dropped it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Roethlisberger. And they get to him with a pressure as Roethlisberger goes down. Elvis Dumervil in there to get him for sack number 9 now on the year. And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. Here's Hester. Officially just 27 yards there on the punt. And the Ravens set up well to begin their drive, as it'll begin in enemy territory already. Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. Now Allen. And he'll be taken down at the 34. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
The best defensive lineman, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. Have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Give him 8 yards there. Still a few inches to go, though, as it'll be third down at about the length of the football. So following the run, we'll see what they do here on third down. Now a carry for Allen. And they pick up the first down there with a gain of four.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
So the offense has it first and 10. Here's Allen, and he stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Well, he was stopped on that play, but he's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then, the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
A break from the ground game here. Flacco, quick hitter here, it's complete. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup, and that'll bring up a third and one.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible, hope he's got man-to-man coverage, and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
And Charles, a couple extra defensive backs in here on third and one.
Not expecting them to run it at all.
And he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. He needed a yard, that's what he got, and it's going to earn him a new set of downs.
Everyone understood their role on that play. Third and one, you know the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive lineman, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a first down.
And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him, so when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
They'll give it to him right up the gun. And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. Buck Allen, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Ravens will add on to their lead. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Throwing now, Roethlisberger on first down. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's brought down. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Whether it's what we call an even front or an odd front, and an odd front's real easy to figure out. If that guy is lined up over the nose of the center, typically that's an odd front defense. Odd number of people, meaning 3-4 versus the 4-3, which is an even front. You've got to control those guys in the middle.
Now Ben hit, and he lost the football. It's loose. And they're going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. And now here come the Ravens. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counterpunch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
Let's see if they dial it up this drive.
Really strong, effective run there out of a power set or a heavy set. Three tight ends in the game, and that's tough for a defensive coordinator. They want to spot that lineup coming into the game early so they can get the proper defensive personnel on the field. That's why the coordinator is relying on some of the assistants to tell him what offensive personnel is hitting the field so he can adjust accordingly. They weren't able to stop him on that run.
And on second and 10 now. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Call it 6, maybe 7, but now they're left with fourth down and goal.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved them and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This a chip. And the holder's going to keep it. He's going to try to run for it. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. The Steelers' offense now, they head back onto the field. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, because you're exactly
you
right.
Like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving.
And Ben goes down in the end zone, and that'll be a safety. So a failure there to get rid of the football. I don't know in the end that it's going to matter much here with this game, but it yields another 2 points.
Yeah, I think I'm with you. It may not matter a ton with the deficit that's already there, but like my old coach used to say, it sure ain't going to help.
It doesn't help indeed. The Ravens offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And last time, they had it fourth and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive.
A simple tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow them to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And that one good for 16, and the drive will continue. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage, so as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let him know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. When they're moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
And they'll run it here. He's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be 3rd and 3 now.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's brought down after a good gain. A good pickup there, a 22.
Yeah, we all know it's turned into a passing league in the NFL, but that doesn't mean people still don't like to run the football. When you run it that successfully, your offensive line is fired up. What they want to do each and every game is run block. Get out and smack some people. I would say go ahead and run it again.
And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd down.
Partner, I think there's a lesson there. Some days you're just having a really tough time, and for the defense, today has been that day. But after that play, what do you learn? You can still make plays even when the other guy's having success against you.
And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's going to set up a 3rd and goal.
That didn't just feel like good defense there. That felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a third time. No one likes to have the hat trick against them.
They're knocking on the door as they come to the line here on third and goal from the one. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. They've gotten it to the one. Can they get that final yard here on third and goal? And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two. He lost two, and it brings up fourth.
Oftentimes when a guy has a game like this, he's going to take his offensive line out to dinner afterwards. But after a play like that, he may tell them, instead of getting the steaks, guys, we might have to go for the hot dogs.
So they settle for just the three there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the fourth.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the final nail. But three does give him some breathing room and lets him build up a little cushion.
And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 yards with a new rule as he's taken down right at the 20-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And last time they surrendered the safety, we know they don't want to do that again.
That is just one of those oddities in scoring that we get. And it's just so strange to see that go up on the board. And then you got to make sure that that doesn't happen to your team again. They've got to take care of the ball.
But boy, it juices up the defense.
Oh, without a doubt. That's a great way to score some points.
Now Roethlisberger to throw, and no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. They'll wind up losing 10 on the sack, and it'll lead to a third and long. And with a third and 13 here, the defense in a dime look. The slot man in motion right. Now Ben on third and long. And it's caught over the middle by the tight end, Green. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
And the offense moving quickly to the line. To throw here, Roethlisberger. He's going to let it fly. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, third down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a fourth down. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Here we go. It's Roethlisberger on fourth down. Over the middle here to Brown. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Ravens are looking like they're going to come away with a victory. And they'll start this drive with very good field position. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
And they'll go on the ground. And he'll be taken down at the 34. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go. And this defense looks for one more stop here on third after the run. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. Now the Steelers put a stop to the action with a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. They'll run for it. This is Allen. Boy, fought off the tackle, and that effort gives him the first before he's brought down. Their season ends here, a tough way to go out.
And the goal was to not just get to the wild card game, which they did, but to win it. And so now, how negative do you look at that? They got there, had an opportunity, and for some teams, they have to lose games like this before they learn how to win them in later seasons.
Mattress.